Hi, in this video I want to make a little 40 foot long arch bridge. It's just a bridge you might find in a park or over a small stream, something like that. And it's held in place with a couple of concrete abutments. So how do we get started? Let's start a new file. Get rid of this young lady. And I want to make it 40 feet, so I'm going to start this way. I'm going to make a 40 foot long line on the green axis, 40 feet. And then I'm going to take the arc. That's 20 feet. Zoom out a little bit. There's 40 feet. And then I want to make sure it's on the blue line, and I want to go 24 inches. Right? The bottom of the first beam right here, right there, is 24 inches off the ground. We're going to start this way. So I can get rid of this line and I have my bottom of my beam. Now I want you to just look at that beam a little bit. The way SketchUp works is it makes everything a series of lines. So if I go to the entity info, I can see it's an arc with 12 segments. So it has 12 lines, and if I can show you, I'll go to 2. And that's not something we'd want. So for this one, we may go to 50 and get a smoother line. But you got to be careful, because the smoother your lines, the more surfaces you can create, and then your model may slow down. So if you can get away with, you know, if you look at it, can you see much of a difference between 20 and 50? Not really. So 20 would be a lot better for the model size, but let's leave it at 50. Alright, so I have the bottom of my first beam. What I'm going to do now is take my tape measure, go along the green axis, let's see, green, 20 feet out, and then I'm going to go down with my guide from the center of the beam, 101 feet. So that's where I can put my radiuses from my other circle. And I'll put another guideline here. And I'll go to the end of the beam, and you'll zoom in a little bit, find the end. Put another guideline at this end. And I can start drawing my first beam. So let's get the circle. And I missed it. Let me click it again. Grab the circle right here. And you can see in the bottom I have 24 sides. Well, that's not really good enough. I would actually, for this beam, it's a small bridge, I'm going to go to 100 sides, 100S, hit return, and now I should get something a little bit better. Well, got to rotate it so I get my circle to be on the right axis. And what did I want for the top of the beam? I wanted 101 feet, don't need a space or anything, 10 inches. You can see that the circle is still kind of rough, so I may go down and make it 200. Can I do it? 200S. Nope, can't do it. Entity. I've got 100 segments. I want to change it to 300. Just make it a little smoother. So if you look at it, made it 10, 20, 30. You can see if you really want a smooth curve, you got to go way up there. So I'm going to go 300. And now what I can do is I can get rid of that. And I can follow my guides, start at the end. This is a nice 90 degree angle now. Go to the other side. Follow my guide. And now I can get rid of the rest of the circle. And there's my first beam. And I'm going to make a beam 3 inches wide by push-pulling it. And I'd have to do some analysis to see if this beam could carry the load, but that's another course in your future. Let's just triple click on it and make it a component. And I'm going to call it Arch Beam. and just create it. And I want this bridge to be 10 feet total width, so I'm going to copy this one from this corner here. Hold the Control key down, go on the red line, and I'm going to type in 9.75 feet. And that should take me, so outside to outside is 10 feet. And then I'm going to divide by 2, and I have my bottom system, the beams that are going to carry the bridge. All right. Well, what else do I need? Well, let's start with some diaphragms. Diaphragms are braces that go between these to stop it from buckling. If you put a load on an arch, it could twist and then it'll fail. The strength will go out of the section. So we can go to this one right here and just sort of copy over a guide. Let's get the guide. And let's say 1.5 inches. And I can just draw a little, since it's a component, nothing I draw will stick to it. So I can just draw a nice little rectangle on it. Let's see here, make sure it gets right to the line. Intersection, corner. And I have a little face. And I'm gonna pull it across. And I'm gonna just pull it to there. And I'm gonna triple click on this and make it a component and call it a brace. Now I can just click on it, grab this one right here, go to that corner and copy it over. And I have a nice brace to keep it from buckling, these arch beams. So I can select the two of them now, right? I can select the two of them. And if you go down to your beginning guide point, you can grab the rotate tool, and as long as it's perpendicular to the red axis like it's showing, right? Click once there. Zoom back in where you want to start from, and I want to start from this side right here, this endpoint. I'm going to hit the Control key and start going. I can let go of the Control key once I start the copy. And I'm going to zoom over to this side here, and you might have to just rotate a little bit so you can see it, but I want to end right at the end of that beam. Zoom in a little bit more. Right there. And before I do anything else, I'm going to go... Oh, I should have copied both of them, and I didn't do that. So let's go back and do it again. Hold that one, hold the Shift key down, grab that one. Go back to rotate. Make sure it's on the red angle. Go up and grab the corner. Right there is where I want to start. Hold the Control key down and start copying. Once I start copying, I let go of the Control key. And then zoom in over here. And you can see I copied that one and I didn't delete it. But what we'll do is we'll just copy it again. Click out. Well, now before I click out, it's getting a little complicated. I should have erased that first one, but I'll erase it after I do this next thing. Before I do anything else, I want to go divided by 10. And I just put some braces in 10 equal spaces. I can click out. Now I have two here, so I can get rid of one. And I just deleted it, so I should be okay. So I kind of messed it up, but I think I saved it. So there's the bracing for the bottom system. So let's put a floorboard on. And it's essentially the same sort of thing. A 2x10 floorboard is 1.5 by 9.25, right? Just because it's called 2x10, that's not the actual size. So I'm just going to copy out a line, and you can see you can copy it on the green axis, or you can copy it, and what I'm doing is right on the face. You can see I'm dragging it on the face, and I'm going to go 9.25, and I go to there. So I'm going to draw, and everything's a component, so I won't stick to it. I'm just going to draw a floorboard. to that corner, go way over here to this corner, to that corner. Oops, too fast to zooming in. And then I'm going to push pull it an inch and a half, 1.5. And then I'm going to triple it, triple click, and I'm going to right click, make component, and I'm going to call it floorboard. Now it's a component. So now what I can do is I can click on it, go down to my point that I started with, grab my rotate, make sure you get the red angle, that's what I want. Click once, go up, find this corner right here, endpoint, hold control till you start, and then just move it down to the other end. Right to that end. And before you do anything else, go divide by 40. Well, they're kind of far apart, so divide by 45. Divide by 50. And I want a little bit of a joint, and you can actually figure out the length of it, but I'm just going to divide by 50, and that's what I'm going to live with. And if I measured it, I have something like, 3/8 of an inch. That should be enough for expansion, contraction. And you can see that it's not perfect, because this is a straight line board and you're putting it on a curve, right? And you could make this curve smoother and you could rotate all the boards perfectly, but I think for this this project, I think people out in the field would get it, that you're going to just nail down these boards on the curve and the board should curve a little bit with the bottom arch, right? Okay. So we've got everything there, the bottom of the bridge. Now I need the handrails. So I'm going to go down here. Everything's a component. And I'm going to draw another circle. And I've got 100 sides in the corner. I'm going to make it 200. And I'm going to go down here. And we're going to go up. The bottom of the rail is 104 feet, 104. 8.5 inches, right? And then I'm going to draw another circle. It's already set at 200. And I'm going to draw it at 104, 10 inches. So we'll zoom right in. And it didn't seem to work. Let's try this again. Oh, look what I did. I forgot the 104 feet 10 inches. That time it worked. But then I made the circle not smooth enough. So let's go to the entity. And I don't know why it didn't change, but 200. That's a little smoother. I could make this one 200 as well. And they're both a little smoother. So if you don't catch it right away, you can click on it, use the entity, and change the circle properties. If you didn't see it, I'll zoom in a little bit here. So I grabbed the out one, and let's say I made it 50. You can see it's just a series of 50 straight lines, and if you make it 200, it's a little bit smoother. This is the top of the railing. This is the bottom of the railing. So all I have to do is join these together, and then I'll go to this other side, use my guides. And I can delete the rest of the circle. And I'll reverse the face so I get the outside is what I want. And there's my handrail, a nice curve. And a handrail, I made it a 2x4 handrail. So I'm just going to bring it out 3.5 inches. Remember, 2x4 is the nominal size. The actual size is 1.5 by 3.5 typically. So I'll go 3.5 out. And there's my rail. And you can see that it's just a series of straight lines. You can make it as smooth as you want. I'm going to triple click on it, make it a component, call it handrail. And now I can just copy it. I'm going to click on it, grab this corner right here, hit the control key. And once I start copying it, once I'm on the red line, I'm going to hold the shift key down. And I'm just going to shift it over until I get to this corner. I'm going to say I want it to stop right there and use the guides. right? So pretty good. All right, so let's go down here. And I already have a line drawn and its axis there. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take this line, excuse me, and I'm going to pull it. It's parallel 3.5 inches because I'm using a 4x4 post, excuse me, and a 4x4 post is 3.5 by 3.5. So I've got those lines, and then I can pull it this direction, 3.5, and this direction on the red line, come on, right there, 3.5. And so now I can just sort of start drawing my shape. Did I get it all? Yep. And you could just try and push-pull it, but what may happen because of the angle, let's just watch it. You can see what happens is it's going to be a little bit off-kilter, and that's not too bad. And that's because of the curves and the way the post is, so I'm just going to push-pull it and draw it. I mean, draw it instead of push-pulling it, so I'll just draw it. It's one side. Sorry if I'm jumping around too much, but I sort of think you get the idea here. Did it close the other side? Not yet, so I just have to sort of close it up. And probably need a line from this corner to that corner. And for the life of me, I don't know why it all is reversed the wrong way, but let's reverse the faces. All right, I'm going to triple click it and make it a component post. I should be able to just copy it over here to this corner, hold the control key down, and it's good. Now I'm going to select another one by either using the shift or the control key. I'm going to go down, hit rotate, go to the spot I need right there. Start the post at this corner here, hold the control key down, I can let it go now, go to the other side, and then before I do anything, divide by 20. So you can see the posts are not quite square. Let's see how close they match up to the curb. Right? Unless a client looks at it, you can see that there's a bit of an angle, and that's because of the way SketchUp works. Again, it's a bunch of straight lines. It's not a true curve like you'd get something in MicroStation. Well, it's not a bad bridge. Everything's a component. Let's draw a little bit of an abutment. And I think I'm going to go and delete the guides. I don't think I need them anymore, so I'm going to delete all of them. And I'm going to draw a little abutment. And I never gave you dimensions for an abutment, so you can make it anything you want. I'm going to start by saying, well, I want it to rest about, and I'm following this line, about, I don't know, 12 inches. So that it sits on that a little bit. And then I want it to be about 2 feet deep. And, I don't know, fairly big abutment, 36 inches to give it some weight. Now I'll go back to this corner here. I can draw from this corner and I can follow this edge to there. And here's a bit of a trick. So you can go on an axis like the green axis, but if you follow this line, watch I'm following it, you can see it turn purple. Now if I hold the shift key, I can draw and it's on that line. So there's the purple. So I want to keep the slope of the bridge going down, and I'm just going to go like some distance, and then I'm going to go up and join it, and then I can erase these little ends, reverse the face, Where is my reverse? Ah, yeah. Reverse the face. And I'm just going to push pull it to this other side. And I have an abutment, right? The load is coming down and pushing on this block of wood or concrete. It'd probably be buried. And then you'd probably have a path that would come off something like this into the park, right? A little bit of a slope. And I'm going to triple click on that. And I'm going to make it a component called an abutment. Now I want to put it back on this side too, so I'm going to copy it. Doesn't matter where, just copy it over. And here's a trick that you can use to mirror something. Once I have it selected, I go to scale. And you pick the one right in the middle. And you go, if you look in the bottom corner, or I mean the bottom right, you just go -1, and it'll reverse it. So it's like using a mirror command. Then I can move it to the corner right from here to this corner right there. And I have a little bridge. Now the advantages of components. If I go to the components window in the model, well, let's say I want to pick the abutment. I can go select instances of the abutment, and you'll see I selected two of them. And I can paint them, and I'm just going to make it gray. And it's a little hard to say, but they painted both of them. All right, so then I want to go to the handrail, select instances. I'm selecting the handrail, and I don't know what color I want to make this bridge. Orange. Select the posts. I'm going to make those, I don't know, yellow. I can select the floorboard, right click, select instances, and I can paint those green. I can select the beams, make those some awful colors. This is an awful colored bridge. And I can select the braces and make those a different color. Oops, undo that one. All right, so I made this an awful looking colored bridge. But that's the advantage of components. The other advantage of components is, let's say I open this post and I don't like the look of it, but maybe I do something like that and something like that, and I push pull away this section here, and I push pull away this section here. Well, all of a sudden I've got an interesting looking bridge, right? I've changed the posts, and you can replace the posts and you can change the posts. I don't like that, so I'm going to undo it until I'm back to where I was. But I don't like this connection, so I'm going to double click on this, and I'm just going to make that go about 3 inches longer. Now, you'll see this little line here, and when you print it out, you'll see that little line, so you don't want to see it, maybe. You can't delete it, because if you delete it, you'll lose the top surface. But there's a thing where you can click it, right-click, and you can soften it, and it kind of hides it. And if I go to the view hidden geometry, it's still there. It's still a line with two edges. But the soften just hides it, so when you print it out, you can't see that line. And you can see over here it lengthened because I did it to the one component. So I'm going to go to the other side here. Double click. Push pull it 3 inches. And, you know, I give it a nice little finished edge. So that's really a fast bridge. And everything is a component, so it won't stick to anything. So you could just make some ground really fast. Let's say I make a field really fast, reverse face it, right? Double click it, Maybe I'll bring it up just a little bit. Five inches. Let's see how it looks at the end. 6 inches, 7 inches, 6 inches, 6.5. Can't have a toe catch there. So I did that. So the abutment's kind of hidden. You go and walk over it, and it's going to be over a small stream. So I'll just make a small stream somewhere in here. Grab this line, just move it over a little bit. What am I going to do? Some vegetation, put some grass down, and then I'm going to put some water. I don't know. Not the greatest water. Later on, I'll show you how to put better textures on. But there's a little bridge. You can go to the warehouse and get some trees for the background, all sorts of things, some better water, and fix it in GIMP or Photoshop. So that's a quick overview of how to make a bridge. Give it a try.